NFL Week 3 is here. The Dallas Cowboys heading on the road to take on the undefeated Seattle Seahawks. Seattle is a 5-point favorite in this game. So right off the bat, I want you guys to predict the score of this game for me. Cowboys at the Seattle Seahawks. Let me know what you think it's going to be in the comments section. Now, after you do that, we are doing a deal here. The first person to correctly predict the score will win $25. Now, in the past, we've just had you guys put this in the comments. We're going to mix it up here a little bit. I want you guys to email cowboys@chatsports.com in order to do this, because we've had issues with certain people. I'm not going to name any names. Certain people have been editing their score after the game ends trying to cheat. We can see that you edited it. It says edited on YouTube. Like, I don't know who you're trying to fool there. So, instead of putting it just in the comments, again, feel free to do so. Doesn't hurt. If you want to be eligible for the $25 on Venmo, email us at cowboys@chatsports.com. That way you can't edit, and it makes it a lot easier for us to immediately identify who won the game. Don't forget, by the way, to actually include which team wins. If you just type in score prediction 25-28, I don't know who that is. You're not going to count. So email us, cowboys@chatsports.com, if you want to be eligible to win the $25. Do it right now. All right, let's talk injuries now here for the Dallas Cowboys, and there are a lot of them. Cheeto, he's out. He's not going to be eligible. He's not going to play with a hamstring injury. Trevon Diggs is really borderline probable for me. DeMarcus Lawrence, he's questionable. Tyron Smith, questionable. I think Diggs will be able to play. He missed practice on Wednesday, returned today, Thursday, as we sit here filming this, suffered that injury against the Falcons. It's a shoulder issue. The reality is that the Cowboys need Trevon Diggs out there. Like, they don't have the options right now. You're down two of your top three corners. Anthony Brown and Awuzie, they're out this week against Tyler Lockett and DK Metcalf. I would think you'll see Diggs more, or even potentially Worley, on Metcalf more just because of their size. Lewis maybe on Lockett, but he might be the nickel guy. It's a tricky situation here. So I am curious to see what the Cowboys end up doing with so few just available options at the quarterback spot. I think Diggs will play. We'll see what happens, but they need him out there in Week 3. Tyron Smith, meanwhile, continues to try and recover from his neck stinger issue. He'll be yet another game-time decision for Week 3, even though Stephen Jones said has a great chance to play, and he's going to be a game-time decision, which those don't really make sense at all. Brandon Knight stepped in as a replacement for Tyron Smith, and I thought he was fine. I actually think he's played better than Terrence Steele. The run game has been a bit better with Steele versus Knight, but not enough that it makes up for the clear difference in mistakes and pressures allowed. So if Smith plays, I want Knight on the right side. We will see if the Cowboys choose to do that, but I'm not sure Smith will play this week. The Cowboys are being very vague with that neck issue. But get your votes in here. Do you think Tyron Smith is going to play? Type 3 for yes or type 4 for no. Let me know what you guys think if you think Tyron's going to be able to play in Week 3. Let's go now to DeMarcus Lawrence, who battled an apparent knee injury in Week 2. When he did try and come back in, he wasn't very good. I think there's a better chance of Tank playing in Week 3, but he needs to be better. Like, Lawrence has not made an impact this year. Outside of one pass breakup when he batted the ball down on third down, that was the big-time play. The six tackles, that's it. That's all he's done. He's been a great run stopper, but you need DeMarcus Lawrence to be better. You have to have him better. Everson Griffin's been, I think, the best defensive lineman, but that's really not saying anything. Alden Smith had a great week one. Now, Lawrence wasn't at practice Wednesday or Thursday. His wife did just give birth, though, so we'll see what ends up happening with Tank. It is a potential concern here, but that's going to be a problem for the Dallas Cowboys. If he can't go, they don't have the edge rushers out there to make up for it, although it is a bad, as we'll discuss, Seahawks offensive line. Now, we're doing some deals for you guys here. BetUS, head over to chatsports.com/bet. Use promo code Cowboys125. That will get you a 125% deposit bonus. And for the rest of the month, we will be giving away Cowboys jerseys to any new depositors who sign up and place a bet. That is only for new depositors. It's chatsports.com/bet. Use the promo code Cowboys125. As a reminder, you can email us at cowboys@chatsports.com. That is cowboys@chatsports.com. If you want to get in on that deal, we'll hook you up with a jersey. Again, it is only for new BetUS customers. That's all you have to do. That's fine. chatsports.com/bet. Promo code Cowboys125. That will get you a 125% deposit bonus. It is only available for new BetUS customers. Let's discuss now some Dak and Russell Wilson conversation here. So, both of these quarterbacks playing very well this year. Dak, almost 69%, super nice. Russell Wilson, meanwhile, has been the best quarterback in the entire NFL, which is pretty crazy to think about here. He's been awesome. This is a very difficult matchup for the Dallas Cowboys because Russell Wilson is awesome. Russell Wilson can use his legs. The Cowboys are bad, historically speaking, against quarterbacks who can run. To be quite honest, folks, I think that Russell Wilson is the better quarterback than Dak Prescott. So get your votes in. R for Russ or D for Dak Prescott. I lean R. I understand those of you who want to type in your D. I respect it, and that's phrasing, but it's okay. I think Wilson's a better quarterback. I like Dak a lot, but it's going to have to be a Dak Prescott-led victory with the way this defense has been playing. Now, offensively for both of these teams, you're looking at two of the best offenses in the NFL. Seahawks are second in points. Cowboys are second in total yards. The passing offense has been on fire. The turnovers kind of hurting the Cowboys. Three giveaways, that's bottom half of the NFL right now. The biggest concern I've got with this Cowboys offense is the offense line. We talked about Tyron Smith. We will see if he's able to go. Brandon Knight, Terrence Steele have not been the best tackles available. Lael Collins, he's out. I don't think Tyron Smith is going to be able to play. On the bright side, the Seahawks pass rush is not good. It is not a good pass rush. LJ Collier hasn't done much of anything. Bruce Irvin is now out for the year. The Cowboys in the first 2 weeks have been hesitant to throw the ball deep downfield because they haven't trusted their offensive line to protect Dak Prescott. But I think this week they're going to be able to. Now, Gallup only has 10 targets. As the team's more utilized deep threat, I think there's a chance for Gallup to get more involved. Now, I still don't think he becomes the leading receiver. Quite simply, folks, I'm looking at CeeDee Lamb. The Seattle Seahawks are going to be without their top nickel corner. Marquise Blair, unable to go. He's out for the year. So, the leading receiver against the Seahawks, I'm going to type in my MG. I'm going to type in my, or excuse me, I'm going to type in my CD. Totally misspoke there. I think CeeDee Lamb is going to have his quote-unquote breakout game. I think like 7 catches, 100 yards, and a touchdown-esque performance out of Lamb. I am very excited to see what he can do this week. Of course, the Seahawks have our good friend Jamal Adams. You guys remember him? Yeah, I think everyone does. He's playing for Seattle. He'll be roaming the middle of the field. He's going to make some plays. He is the one player that I'm going to be most concerned about. Not so much in the pass coverage, but rushing against the quarterback. When he's blitzed, he's gotten home twice already this year and has legitimately been the Seahawks' best pass rusher this season. As a reminder, folks, we were live week one during the game. We were live for that improbable comeback against the Atlanta Falcons and we'll be live again in week three. So if you want to join our fun watch parties, we kind of bring the bar to you guys. We have some beers during the game, after all. Hit that subscribe button. It'll be Cowboys focused, as always, in a potentially pivotal game against the Seattle Seahawks. Let's talk defense then here for the Dallas Cowboys. Frankly, both of these defenses are not good. The points per game favors Seattle, but no one in the NFL has given up more yards or more passing yards than the Seahawks have. Over 415 through the air, 485 on average total. Now, they've made it up with three takeaways, but their run defense is good. As a reminder, let Dak sling it. It works out pretty well. The Cowboys are going to require, though, when they are on defense, to find a way to get pressure. It simply hasn't worked out very well so far for the Cowboys. DeMarcus Lawrence, bit of a non-factor. Alden Smith, Everson Griffin have taken turns making plays. Week one for Smith, week two for Griffin. But overall, it's not remotely good enough. The unit has not played in the way they need to. But they might get a break here. The Seahawks offensive line isn't that great. Dwayne Brown, I like him a lot. Brandon Shell is not a good player. Damian Lewis is a first-year rookie, better in the run game than the passing game. They can take advantage against this Seahawks offensive line. I genuinely don't care who it is. I don't care if it's Alden Smith. I don't care if it's Everson Griffin, Tyrone Crawford, Tank if he plays, Dorrance Armstrong, Bradley Knight, I don't care. Somebody is going to have to start winning individual matchups. It hasn't happened anywhere near at the rate it's going to need to with the way this secondary is currently constructed for the Dallas Cowboys. So if Tank plays, I feel good about his chances. If Griffin plays, I think he's been trending in the right direction. Alden Smith, I've seen some promise there. Somebody's going to have to emerge. Somebody has to. We'll see what it ends up being. With that in mind, let me know what you guys think. How many sacks will the Dallas Cowboys put together in week three? I'll put the over-under at 2.5. That would exceed their season production. I think there is a possibility for it. But if you're the Cowboys, your plan this season was pass rush gets home, covers up a poor secondary. That poor secondary is already down two starters and now faces one of the better duos at receiver they're going to face all season long. Tyler Lockett and DK Metcalf. Lockett's been targeted 16 times. He's caught 15 of them. Wild. 159 yards and a touchdown. DK Metcalf took on Stephon Gilmore last week and won. I like Diggs. He is not Stephon Gilmore. I am worried about the size and speed of DK Metcalf. Lockett's one of the more underrated players in the NFL. If your pass rush does not get home, if you're the Dallas Cowboys, you're going to be in trouble. Overall, you know that Russell Wilson's going to get his. You are going to have to allow your offense chances. So that means stopping some third downs, getting some turnovers if you get lucky, getting a takeaway or two. The defense is behind the eight ball. I am concerned about it, but we will see what the Cowboys can do. That defense, I think it's going to be a shootout. Just takeaways is going to be my emphasis this week for that secondary and that pass rush. Hey, Cowboys fans, thanks for watching the Cowboys Report. If you haven't already, click right here to subscribe to our channel for all the best Cowboys coverage on the internet. That's news, rumors, highlights, mailbags, film studies, and a whole lot more. And I'm making your lives a little bit easier as well with the next Cowboys Report video right here.